Rough House was a division of Columbia Records, one of the biggest music labels in the world, and I was on it. Now everybody would get to hear my music, and now it was time to tell Tashura something. What y'all think he gonna tell her? Girl, I'm on a crack tour. You in the way. If you ain't selling tickets, get out the way. Did DMX wait to page 200 and let's say 12 to get to the fucking point? Answer yes. Are we finally there? Answer yes. Have we been waiting for this moment all of our lives? Answer yes. Finally, we get to the part of the book that matters. Not that way, way.
The production agreement that Wah signed with me and Jack, who based on his managerial contract with me, had the right to approve any deal that I wanted to make, was to put together an original single in 6 months' time. So the first thing Wah and I had to do was learn what a hot beat was. Once I didn't need them to keep me out of jail anymore, I didn't deal with the COs too much. They were good guys, and I had gone over to their spot a few times to spit some rhymes with them, but they just didn't have the tracks I wanted. So almost every night for the next few weeks, me and Wah hunted down all the young producers in the city and listened to the tracks they had. Chad Dr. Seuss Elliott was a producer that Wah had met who had been working with a group called Jodeci at Uptown Records. When he played us his material, I knew right away that I could match some of my rhymes to what he had. They were raw and sounded real hard. The first rhyme I wanted to use was Born Loser. The second I called Catching the Same Hell. And within a week, Wah and I decided that those two songs should become the two sides of my first 12-inch vinyl single. No more rhyming off of other artists' instrumentals. Now I had my own shit. I knew that if we pressed up 500 copies of Born Loser on vinyl and gave them out to radio DJs and club promoters, we could get the song buzzing on the street. Once that happened, then record stores would take notice and we could start taking orders and selling copies to everyone. The science behind doing a single was the same as selling mixtapes. The payoff was just bigger. One night, Ed Lover and Dr. Dre, who were the evening DJs on WBLS, announced that Born Loser was on their nightly countdown. The following week, two Long Island radio stations followed the lead of BLS and added the song to their own weekly rotation. Born Loser, the first rhyme that I had ever put on wax, was getting airplay, and I was amped. Moving forward, Wah didn't like Jack. He felt he was a clown-ass ninja who wasn't capable of taking me to the next level. And the more time I spent with Wah, the more I agreed with him. Child. Hold tight. My music was hard, grimy street music, because I was a grimy street nigga, and that was the only way that I felt I should represent myself. I knew a dude that was just as grimy and greasy, but that ninja was like Teflon. And the thing about it was, every time they tried to murk his ass, it was over him messing with somebody else's girl. Okay, he the type of dude that you would never let drive your car. Never! Because if you let him drive it, he gonna bring that mother hunchy back with bullet holes. You hear me?
They tried to get him. They could never get him. But they got his son.
If I was to succeed, I wanted it to be with hood niggas. Hood niggas who shared a dream with me. Hood niggas who knew how to handle their business. Jack was not that. I didn't tell him that then, but he wasn't stupid. Jack knew he was losing me. So this is the thing. You know, he's still living with the dude, Jack. All right. He come in the house one day because he done made up his mind. Fuck him because he old bitch ass. DMX come in the house. Tashir looking at him like, what the hell? What is happening? Ain't right. Okay. Don't forget, while we're going through this book, ever since he stated in his book that he was dealing with his addiction, he ain't stopped smoking. Tashir supposedly didn't know. Women who are like Tashir, it's people that's always telling them who their partner is. They just don't absorb it because they don't want to. They don't want to believe or acknowledge that their partner may actually be that nigga that's stealing TVs. DMX stealing TVs. So DMX is coming into the apartment that he shares with Jack. Tashir is there waiting on him. Tashir like, what's wrong with you? Why are you looking all crazy like that? He ignores her. Go to the wall. Pulls the TV off the wall. Tashir like, what are you doing? What's wrong with you? Some women, the signs are right there. They could be stealing money out your purse. This dumb bitch walking in the walls talking about, I don't know what happened to that 20. I know I brought it into the house. Baby, did you see that 20? He look at your dumb ass and say, no, baby, I ain't seen that 20. Can I borrow 20? The 36-inch television that my manager had in his living room now belonged to me. Tashir, get out the way and just leave me alone. She actually tried to stop me from taking it. Earl, you can't walk out with Jack's TV. She had her arms wrapped around one end of the set and was trying to pull it away from me. But she couldn't stop me, not in the darkness that I was in. The thing about addiction is, as long as you got the money, you just fine. Okay? It's when you ain't got the money that everything turns into a problem. What I say? It's never a problem until it's a problem. And when you ain't got that money to buy whatever it is you need, oh, bitch, it's a problem. As I was walking away from the house, I heard her on the phone. Yo, Jack, I don't know what the F is wrong with Earl, but dot, dot, dot. You know what the F is wrong with Earl. He's smoking them crackers. Jack pressed charges. Wah tried to help the situation by finding who I sold the television to. But the damage had already been done. That weekend, on the strength of Born Loser, I performed at a new artist showcase at the Jack the Rapper Music Conference in Atlanta. When I saw Jack there, Wah urged me to apologize. It was the right thing to do, but that was the last time I would see or speak to my manager for many years. A few weeks later, Wah and Darren hired a lawyer to sever my management agreement with Jack McNasty. A few days after that, in a meeting with Rough House Records, I was offered a recording contract for Born Loser. It was only a deal for one song, but it was still a deal. Rough House was a division of Columbia Records, one of the biggest music labels in the world, and I was on it. Now everybody would get to hear my music, and now it was time to tell Tashir something. What y'all think he gonna tell her? Girl, I'm on a crack tour. You in the way. If you ain't selling tickets, bitch, get out the way. He ain't say that. I couldn't bear the thought of lying to her anymore. So one night I called her from a payphone and asked her to meet me outside right away. What happened, Earl? Are you all right? Tashir, I have something to tell you. When she arrived, I gave it to her straight. Girl, I'm out here chasing crackers. I told her that I didn't want to mess with her anymore because she was a real good person and I had a problem. Now, I will give DMX kudos for that because a lot of selfish niggas would have kept her around. When she arrived, I gave it to her straight. I told her that I didn't want to mess with her anymore because she was a real good person and I had a problem. I told her it was something that I had to deal with on my own. No, you don't, Earl. Tashir, you don't understand. I'm saying, so what, Earl? We could do this. She was calm. I was getting hysterical. Do what? What are we going to do? Do you know how dark it gets? Yes, she do know how dark it gets. This is why I'm thinking something is wrong with Tashir. Bitch, didn't you see him grab that TV off the wall and head out the door with it?
Go! It gets darker.
Push the bitch out the way. Bitch, get out the way. He don't want cat today. He about to get something else today. So it gets dark.
And to sure, I don't understand this lady. Anyway, come to find out, Tashura was pregnant. I was holding my healthy baby boy, Xavier. He was all wrinkled and peely. Me being DMX had a lot to do with calling my son Xavier. My name, for me, had become the label of an official mother sucker. And since I knew that everyone would call him Little X anyway, as soon as I heard the name Xavier, I knew that would be special. The children always paid for the sins of their parents. A few months earlier, Tashura and I had moved in with my sister, Benita. After the TV incident, Tashura lost her place with Nicole, too, so neither of us had a place to live.
Was it because when you stopped stealing TVs, you started stealing money out of her purse and she couldn't afford to pay her half of the rent?
We stayed in my grandmother's house for a few weeks until it got too crowded with all of my uncles and aunts running around. Then we stayed with Tashura's father for a minute. Over the years, he and Tashura had made peace, but when he started harassing me about all the sins I was committing and busting me for stealing shiz from him, we had to leave, and we had been in my sister's place ever since. Despite the fact that Rough House re-released the song as a proper 12-inch single, Born Loser never took off. It stayed on the WBLS countdown for a few more weeks, but never made it to number one and never caught heat anywhere outside of the YO or New York area. The label said that it didn't have the kind of hook or club beat it needed. I felt that Rough House didn't put enough marketing power behind it, so not enough people heard the song in the first place. I knew enough to know that you needed hype to sell records. Around the way in YO, I was my own hype, but I couldn't help get myself on the radio in Chicago or LA. But after it died with me having only a one song deal, it also became clear that Rough House wasn't interested in pursuing anything further with me or Wah or Rough Riders. And within a few months of me having my own major label single, a song on the radio, my professional recording career was over. Wah was determined to keep going though. So one afternoon, Wah and Irv Lorenzo, not yet Irv Gotti, went down to a music store in Manhattan, and Wah bought him a used MPC 60 sampler with $2,000 in cash. I thought $2,000 was a big investment in a kid that we didn't know that well. But it wasn't my money, and it was hard finding producers that wanted to dedicate their time to making beats for me. Chad Elliott always had other things going on. Anthony, this other producer kid I knew from Yonkers High School, had started to roll with us. And even though he had done a good remix of Born Loser, he was busier throwing parties and putting his tag, Pent One, up all over the neighborhood that he was laying tracks. Despite being rough and somewhat underdeveloped, his beats were knocking. One of the best songs we made together was a joint called Niggas Can't Touch Me, Kid. One time, they were out hanging out by the radio station. They saw Ed Lover. Ed, I need you to pay attention to this. Here you go. Ding, 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 ding. Pay attention to this. Ed Lover was like, nah, I ain't messing with you. And then, when Ed Lover brushed him off, well, I was pissed off. I thought he was going to chase Ed Lover down and slap him in the back of the head. But before he could get the chance, I saw Wendy Williams walking out. Wendy was the biggest female personality on the station. She had a primetime slot, and because of all of the Howard Stern-like gossiping she did about everybody in hip-hop, she was becoming one of the most known and most hated radio people on the East Coast. She had double parked, but now the car that was next to the curb had pulled off, so she was running to get her joint out of the middle of the street.
All right, give me one, she told Wa in a hurry.
Hey, do my favorite go-go song.
Taking a ride on the east side, made a left on MLK. What a beautiful day, what a beautiful day. Riding high on the west side, looking for a hood where to play. Won't you come out and play, won't you come out and play. Hey, taking a ride. Hey, hey, on the south side. Ooh, ooh, taking a ride on MLK. Hey, 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 we like that good. Say what?